And we're back, gents. Week 2 of the EPL, our review of the games that have just gone past. I'm back again. It's myself, Dibs. I'm here with Sam. Yeah, and man. As we all know, caged the most biased panel you'll ever meet in your life. Reviewing
the definition of character. That's the definition of character. Listen,
reviewing the past week, I'm going to start with you, Sam. Because last week, we had a problem. Yeah. We had to start with the so-called defending champions, as you remember.
We'll
come back to the defending champions. Let's start with you, Sam.
Good week.
Talk us through the game. Listen, what happened in Man United?
It's been a good week for Man United. Old Trafford has been booming. This weekend it was still very tight. But away from home, I'll take the win. 1-0 win. It wasn't convincing. I still think we're getting better and better. But listen, Januzaj came on, so our young kids are playing well, which is always great. It's always good to see. I'd love to see more people score. I'd love to see Rooney. I mean, Rooney's circle entries are bad. Like his 18 entries.
What are you saying about Rooney's performances right now?
Listen, we're concerned. We're concerned. The Old Trafford faithful are concerned. But with that said, Rooney's a professional. As I keep saying this, I said it last week, I'll say it again. Rooney, just like Memphis, we saw Memphis yesterday on the Champions League game. Sneak two away, two brilliant goals, by the way. Rooney's going to do the same thing against me, because
I saw him miss a one-on-one, the kid that you told me.
I'll tell you the good things about the United Villa game. One, it was on a Friday. So I'm really happy that we got the Friday fixture, so we can start the sporting weekend quite early. So that's a great positive.
That's a top positive.
It was. Another good thing about that game was that Januzaj didn't dive, you know.
Because we know he's got
more dives than goals for United.
The biggest positive, I forgot to mention this, the biggest positive is two clean sheets in a row. You can't talk to me, both of you guys, about clean sheets. Two clean sheets in a row.
So is the plan to 1-0 our way to the title?
I've seen Jose do it,
so I can.
No, but no. You see, when you saw Mourinho do it, you guys were out with your pitchforks telling us that we're boring. This is anti-football.
I'm playing boring football.
No, I'm not playing boring football.
What?
I am not executing great football. That is what's happening.
Stop it.
I warned you last week to play boring football. I said, start Zuma in the middle of my teacher. I said, go back to the old ways. You didn't listen.
In fact, we're going to play a clip of what you said.
I know what I said.
What happened?
Because I was there when I said
it. Great. So I know. What happened? What happened, kid? So that we don't laugh. I feel bad.
You perhaps want to start with Arsenal? This requires time.
We're gonna cut the Arsenal story very short.
Yeah.
We did the business.
Exactly what I said was gonna happen, happened. As it happened.
Well, right? We're just one goal shy of what I said would happen.
I'll give you that.
But we outplayed Crystal Palace like I told you.
Oh, Pardew, what's he gonna do?
He slapped him out the way and
that game was not a walk in the park.
You got lucky.
Francis Coughlin.
Listen,
lucky.
The way
Wenger responded, he says, "No, it could be." Why does he put him off 30 seconds?
He knew the crowd. Sammy, in small teams, the crowd.
You're better than that.
Always.
You're better than that.
Listen,
Coughlin.
No.
Was very lucky to stay a lucky boy.
I am disappointed in how at the disrespect that you give to Arsenal.
It's bad disrespect.
We will keep whipping teams as we do.
Coughlin was a lucky boy. A plus for you guys, the Chilean is back. He missed some chances, but he's looking fine.
I think Arsenal's standout player over the weekend was Mesut.
I don't know. I don't know if I'd go as far as to say he's back. I've seen Mesut do stuff like this and then go dry.
Yes. I've seen him very inconsistent in the EPL.
Back!
Is he going to do the same thing against Liverpool?
Of course he is. Worse, I'm scared for Liverpool. I'm like, Liverpool, stay home. Don't come to me.
I really think a big talking point for this weekend was the refs, in all honesty. Like, everything happened, but the refs made some dubious. Francis Coughlin, though you like to admit it, the few offside rules. Schmeichel,
that's part of the game. Though.
Schmeichel closed down.
Fernandinho.
Fernandinho. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, Touré.
Let's slow down.
That's a segue into.
No,
let's just get into what happened.
Let's get there.
Maybe try to explain so we can understand what went down.
Look. I watched the game, and after the game.
Heartbroken?
I had my humble part. One, City played us the same way that they played us last season.
Mm-hmm.
The same way that they play in Europe. Persistent fouling.
Fouling?
Persistent fouling. Silva. How did Silva not get a yellow card?
As a Chelsea fan, how dare you say
No. I want to hear Cage. Yo, what Cage is going to put this loss on?
No, I'm just laying out the variables.
Oh, okay.
Right?
Okay, let's see. Okay,
is it variables?
Okay.
Analysis.
Okay.
And then we'll apply, right?
Okay.
Persistent fouling by City.
Okay.
Right? Fernandinho should have seen a red card. Because if that was Costa, who had played that, everybody would be telling us that no, Costa is a thug.
He's a thug.
Yeah, Torre should have seen the red card.
Mm-hmm.
Why do I blame the loss? City's players looked sharper than us.
We warned you.
They looked hungrier than us.
We warned you.
And the back four, the block, the two centre backs, Malaga company. With Fernandinho and
Yaya,
were very, very solid.
Mm-hmm.
As opposed to our defensive block of Cesc, Matic, Tyrion, and Kane. The whole play, our whole squad was very lethargic.
Mm-hmm.
A very lackluster performance by the group. Ivanovic, which I did say yesterday, was woeful.
Mm.
Ivanovic was woeful. I don't know why Mourinho continues with.
But, so, okay. Last week I was concerned at Ivanovic's form. This week I'm adding to your defensive list. Tell me what Mourinho.
I think
said
this is a tactical. It wasn't a tactical. Why him though?
Because Terry's slow, but not slow, that much slower than Keo. But when we play with Terry, we necessarily have to play. A low block
okay.
In terms of like, you can't play it.
Yeah, you can't.
And for Terry to be Terry, he needs Matic to be on side.
Tell you something.
That's
Matic. It's what's happening now at Chelsea is an explosive. All right, let me tell you something. Mourinho is just about to kill Terry's career. It's done. It's over. Let's pack it in the bag. What it did to Kaká and all those other kids. Let's pack them.
No,
my biggest concern is. You went into that game saying, and you knew, the problem is you knew what you were getting.
Mm.
You said West Brom let City play.
Yeah.
I saw Chelsea let City play.
Alright gents, there you have it. The most biased panel out here.
But we played very well the second half against City. We played very, very well.
3-0 is not playing well.
It's a fake scoreline.
That's nice that you played well.
It's a fake scoreline. 12 goals.
It was a whippy.
With defensive errors.
Had it not been for Begovic, it should have been 7. Sure, I counted 7.
Begovic made way more saves. He needs an extra pay.
That's what it is.
Yeah, and
no,
again, overtime.
That's
from again, that's.